I'm gonna make a few announcements before we'll see, kind of see folks coming in here. Give everybody a few minutes to get in, and I'll start by making some announcements. Welcome, everyone. We're glad you're here. There's a few more people rolling in. Okay, I have a few announcements. Welcome to this session in the Virtual College Fair. We're very excited that you're here. I am the facilitator, and I'm going to turn it over here in just a second to our presenter, but I want to let you know that if you have questions as this work presentation is going on, you can use the Q&A button to ask those questions. Note that your camera and microphone are off. Participants, you're muted. The panelists cannot see or hear you. You can sign up for more of these sessions. We've got a few more this week, and we'd love to have you participate today and tomorrow. And you can find those on www.strivescan.com/Minnesota. All of these sessions are also being recorded. So again, that recording can be found in the next week or so at strivescan.com/Minnesota. And with no further ado, we will get started.
Hi, everyone. I'm Tom Lancaster. I'm with the Minnesota Private College Council. The Minnesota Private College Council represents 17 private colleges in Minnesota. So we'll talk about, we'll talk about individual colleges, but really what we're going to talk about is thinking about a private college and some of the characteristics of private colleges that maybe you all are interested in. I'm first gonna play a quick video here to get you all just quick up to speed about Minnesota private colleges. So here we go. And I hope it's not too choppy.
You're thinking about college. Are you thinking about private colleges? Minnesota private colleges are small campuses with big opportunities. We have 17 distinct campuses that offer more than 140 different majors. We cost less than you might think. Students from all income levels come to our colleges and succeed. 95% receive grants and scholarships. With these grants and scholarships, listed tuition is cut by 61% for first-year students. You are never just a number at a Minnesota private college. Most classes have fewer than 20 students. They are challenged and supported by professors who know them.
In a smaller school, you build a sense of community while you're here. Our financial aid officers are amazing. I have friends who are across the whole spectrum in terms of what they come in with, and they understand that school is an important investment, and they're willing to make it possible for everyone, no matter what background they're coming from.
A lot of my friends, we all talk about how it's not as expensive as we all thought.
I never would have imagined being this close to my professors.
And you get to build a ton of relationships off that.
My classes are only about 12 people. We know everybody in our classes along with our professor very well.
I originally did go to a state school. I felt like just a number. When I transferred, I ended up really enjoying going to a small private school. I knew that the value was there. The professors genuinely do care about you as a student, but then more importantly, care about you as a whole.
That was something really important to me when I was looking at college, making sure I was able to make those connections and being able to succeed with good professors on my side.
Our grads are prepared for what's next, and they start careers sooner. Our four-year graduation rate is the best in Minnesota and the Midwest, and third in the nation. Take a close look at Minnesota private colleges. Our students are supported and engaged. Choose a college that puts you first.
So I hope that worked out, and I hope you all got to see a little glimpse of the beauty of Minnesota private colleges, the campus, the students, and some of the reasons why, you know, Minnesota private colleges are an important choice for you all. We're going to go through some of those topics here and talk about private colleges more in depth right now. So let me start this slideshow from the beginning. Here are the 17 Minnesota private colleges in Minnesota. As you can see, they're spread out across the state. We've got ones in northern Minnesota, the College of St. Scholastica and Concordia College in Moorhead. We've got some in central Minnesota, St. John's and St. Ben's that are connected institutions. We have a number of institutions in the Twin Cities, Augsburg University and Concordia University in St. Paul. We've got a few in Northfield, Carleton College and St. Olaf College, which are right next to each other in Northfield. St. Mary's University is in southern Minnesota. They also have a campus in the Twin Cities. And then in St. Peter and Mankato, we've got Bethany Lutheran and Gustavus Adolphus College. So this is kind of the scope here is really interesting, because if you're interested in school in the city, we've got a number of options. If you're interested in school in the woods, we've got options for that too. So, and everything in between. Like I said, there is a private college that's right for you. I'm not here to sell you on any one. I don't represent any institution. I represent the idea of helping you guys and you all think about your opportunities and what's next. And we know that University of Minnesota is probably on your mind, or a big school is on your mind. And it's important to keep those options open. I certainly wouldn't discourage you from looking at Minnesota State Colleges and Universities, a community college, but I also want to encourage you to think about private colleges and make sure that you're keeping a private college on the top of your list, because there's a private college that's right for you, whether it's close to home or whether it's 5 hours away. There's a private college that'll fit your needs. Maybe you need to be close to home for a reason, taking care of your parents or helping at the house, or maybe you want to get away and this is your time to live your best life and be yourself and you don't want to see mom. We've got options for both those mindsets. We've got, private colleges, we've got 17 of them and we've got 160 majors and minors. I think there's this theory that private colleges only include the humanities, that you have to get an English degree if you go to private colleges. That's just not the case. We've got colleges who have wonderful science, world-class science facilities at some of our institutions. So we've got 160 majors and minors. I would challenge you to think of a major or minor that we don't have at Minnesota private colleges. We are all small colleges. We're all small universities. All 17 of those institutions pride themselves on having small class sizes, but there's a range in that small. Bethany Lutheran has about 700 students in the whole institution, and St. Thomas has about 6,000. So, many of you probably have been are going to a small high school right now, and think of the benefits of that, of class size, getting to know your teachers. In this case, professors that are knowledgeable and often leaders in their field. So, those small small undergraduate numbers there also lead to some really cool interaction. You get to know the student body a little bit more intimately. And then campus life, we know, school is important, class is important, grades are important, but in my opinion, what's more important are the other things. And, we've got campuses that are in the cities where you can go to, music venues and you can take the light rail, and when we're allowed to take the light rail again. But we also have institutions in the woods where they integrate camping and paddling into their curriculum. This wide variety of campus life is really important. And I want you all to think about, what are you looking for in an institution? And because there is a Minnesota private college that will fit that. You know, I briefly mentioned and talked about class sizes. And the way we speak to this is students are never just a number. Looking at a larger institution, you might have some intro classes that have 400 or 500, maybe more students in a classroom. Bethany Lutheran has 700 students in the whole school. So these small institutions have small class sizes, and you're never just a number in those classes. You're a name, you're a person, you have an identity to those professors. The grads see a difference in that. You get to know your professors. You maybe go to their house and have a meal with them. This is a different type of relationship than you'd see at a larger institution. And you'll get more out of those relationships because of that connectivity. You're never just a number with these professors. You're definitely a person. Our student body represents Minnesota, but it also represents more. 68% are from Minnesota, but 28% are from other states in the U.S. and 5% are around the world. 23% are first generation students, and 30% are students of color, Native American. So we're Minnesotans, and it's Minnesota private colleges, but we have institutions that represent so many different types of students and student bodies. So we've got McAllister that really prides itself on its international students and its international student body, and then we've got other schools that are really focused on their community. Concordia College in Moorhead, it prides itself in its location in Moorhead in northern Minnesota, and that's part of who that institution is. So, at Minnesota Private Colleges, students and you all will never just be a number. And ultimately, college is about being prepared for what's next. College is fun, don't get me wrong, but it's also about what happens after college. And our grads, the grads at Minnesota Private Colleges, are prepared for what's next. The median income of our alums working in Minnesota 5 years after graduation is nearly $60,000. And this is really important. I wouldn't encourage you guys to think too much about your work, but your future work, but you will be working in the future. And it's important that college is a stepping stone to the career that you are looking for. And your how much money you're making is going to be an important part of that. Within 1 year of graduation, 74% are employed, 17% are seeking additional education, and 4% are in service. And this is an important element here. This talks about the value of a degree from Minnesota private colleges. People go on, they use their degree, they go on to be employed, they go on to other education. It's really important statistic that we've got so many of our grads really engaging, really engaging with their degree in that way. But most importantly, the students from Minnesota private colleges graduate and start their careers sooner. Our 4-year grad rate is the best in Minnesota, and it's in the Midwest, and second best in the nation. Private colleges have excellent 4-year grad rates. And this is important because a number of things, but one of the reasons why it's important is your financial aid packages are going to be based on a 4-year admission cycle. So if you get the Pell, you get the state grant, you get the Pell grant, maybe you get some institutional aid, maybe you get an outside scholarship. All of those are going to be scheduled in 4-year increments. So, a financial aid package that decreases the cost of college by 75%. That means, let's say you're paying 25% of the listed price. The fifth year is full price. So So 4 years, that financial aid package counts. The fifth year is full price. That's very important. That fifth year is extremely expensive. It's expensive not only because you're paying full price at an institution, but you're also not working and gaining an income, which we know can be upwards of $60,000. So think about that. You're paying full price and you're losing the opportunity for income. So that fifth year is really pricey. If you're talking to other institutions today or in the future, I would ask them about their four-year grad rate, and they might tell you, oh, our six-year grad rate is this. Well, think about that. Fifth and sixth year are very expensive. They are what is causing some of the loan crisis issues that we have, people staying in their undergraduate degrees far too long. Minnesota private colleges graduate you in 4 years at a very high rate. So that's very important. If you don't leave this webinar with anything else, I want you to remember to ask your future college, the colleges that you're looking at as a prospective student, about their four-year grad rate. And if they have a low four-year grad rate, I would ask questions about that. Next, we cost less than you think. And I just spoke a little bit about cost in that last half of that slide. And cost is very important. And I encourage all of you to think about cost. How much can your family afford? What's the value of these degrees? At Minnesota private colleges, we have students from all income levels and they succeed. If you look at that last infographic, the typical family income at Minnesota private colleges is nearly the exact same as the typical family income of Minnesota. Why that's important is there's this notion that private colleges are just for rich kids. They're not. They're for everyone. And right now we're serving all different types of family incomes. So don't feel like, well, that, you know, those institutions aren't right for me. They're not, you know, they don't want me to be at those institutions. Those are for a different type of person. That's just not true. Our institutions are interested in you joining their campus and being part of their community, no matter who you are. After grants and scholarships, remember I was talking about that 75%, and you might've think, Tom, that's crazy. So you're going to give me 75% off. The average after grants and scholarships, our tuition is cut by 64%. That is average. That means that 50% of the students it's cut by more than that. So you're going to see some high sticker prices. You're going to see some colleges that it's like, whoa, it costs $50,000 a year to go there. It does not. The sticker price is $50,000, but each individual student, it costs a little bit different amount to go, depending on your family's income, depending on where you're from, depending on what sort of grants and scholarships you're eligible. 95% of our first year students receive grants and scholarships that don't have to get paid back, that aren't loans. This is money that right into your pocket. This is a way to create value for you and your family are these grants and scholarships. So you're going to see in your future college search, you're going to see some big numbers around tuition. And I just want you to not be scared by those. Take them into consideration. It's a data point and it's an important one to take into consideration, but never say, I can't go to that school because of the tuition. Wait to make that decision until they give you your financial aid package. And that financial aid package comes in the right about now or a little bit, in February, between December and February, you'll get your financial aid package. Then make the decision. That school that costs $50,000 might cost you $10,000 a year. That if you're able to go to a school that charges $50,000 for $10,000, you'd have to look at that. You'd have to take that into consideration. So if you're looking at private colleges and it's like, oh, it's just really expensive, we can't afford, $60,000 a year, just hold off. If it's the right fit, if it's the right school with the right professors and the right student body, keep it very important to keep that in your consideration, and then see the financial aid package. And maybe that school doesn't give you a very good financial aid package, and you can make the decision on that based on the actual cost that you'll have. It's very important. I think there's a lot of students out there who write off colleges based on their sticker price, not knowing that 95% of first-year students receive grants and scholarships. That means that the vast majority of the first-year students on our campuses are receiving, you know, reductions on that tuition. And it's very important. You're not going to know how much that reduction is until you get your financial aid package. That's true for every institution, by the way, not just the private colleges, meaning every institution has financial aid packages and you receive them about the same time. So don't make your decision until you receive those financial aid packages. And then once you receive those financial aid packages, use that as a data point on how to determine what school is right for you. I would say, you know, cost is very important, but when we were talking about grad rates, fit is even more important, because if you can graduate in 4 years because of a good teacher, good extracurricular activity that you're connected, good friends, good student body, if that helps you graduate in 4 years, you could be saving hundreds of thousands of dollars if at another institution you were going to end up going for 6 years. So, you know, it's a balance, right? Matching the right fit with the right cost is ultimately the best way to go. You go to the cheapest institution, you might not end up graduating on time, and you might end up spending more money than you really need to for your undergrad degree. And I'll say one other thing: those 4 year grad rates that we talked about, some of it is about, you know, the type of students that go there, but some of it is about institutions. For instance, there are institutions where, you know, you've got one course in the fall that you need. You've got one course in the fall that you need to graduate, and it fills up and you can't get into that. You've got to wait a whole nother year to have availability in that class for graduation. That costs a whole nother year's worth of tuition, remember, and probably with no financial aid package. Our institutions don't do that. They're small class sizes. Very rarely are classes filling up where you can't get into a class that's needed for a graduation requirement. So some instances, the 4 year grad rate's all about culture and about the type of students and professors, but it's also about the structure of the institution. So that 4 year grad rate's very important. And I'd always encourage every student looking at a college, what's your 4 year grad rate? Not your 6 year grad rate. What is your 4 year grad rate? And if it sounds low, ask them, why is it 30%? Why is it 40%? Why is your grad rate, your 4 year grad, why are only 40% of your students graduating in 4 years? Be honest, ask them, why is that? Because institutions, private institutions, Minnesota private colleges have much higher 4 year grad rates than that. I'll get to some questions at the end here, but I have some other resources. We've got detailed profiles of the 17 private colleges, and I'd really encourage you to go on our website and check these out. This is, once again, we're not here to sell you on any one institution. We're here to give you information about all of these colleges. And there's a really good resource where 17 colleges are at your fingertips, and you can scroll through, figure out what you like about an institution, maybe what you don't like about an institution. Where else can you go on one site and see detailed information about 17 private colleges? It's an absolutely wonderful resource. And anyone who's looking to go to college in Minnesota should be looking at these profiles. These are some of the finest institutions in the state, if not the country, and you have access to 17 of them at your fingertips. Our College Finder tool will help you figure out maybe what's best. Maybe you're interested in, you know, tennis, and you have this GPA and you want to go in this region. It can kind of help you figure out and distill down what are the best options for you. It's like an interactive tool that can sort of help you figure out what, your next step might be. And then very important tool is this net price calculator. And I'm not sure if you guys know what net price calculators are, but they're federally mandated that every institution has a net price calculator on their website. it's going to help you figure out what the actual cost is to go to that institution. So remember I was saying about, you know, 95% of first year students are receiving grants and scholarships. This is going to take into account some of that, some of those financial aid packages. So then you can get a more transparent potential price for you and your family, you know. And I would say you don't need to have your taxes from 2019. You sit down with your family. You know some of these numbers off the top of your head and work with your family and work through those net price calculators. So then you can see, oh, wow, this institution is telling me I'm going to get this amount of financial or roughly this amount of financial aid package. I need to be interested in that institution. Every college, whether it's a private college or not, has net price calculators. And I would encourage you very seriously to use those net price calculators. When I was looking at colleges, they didn't have net price calculators. You had to wait for your financial aid package. Now you can get a glimpse of what that financial aid package will look like whenever you want with these net price calculators. A very cool tool. I'll stop sharing now. And I'm gonna answer a question here. There's a question here about potential reductions of tuition 2 and 3 and 4 years. That's an interesting question that has multiple parts. Once again, a financial aid package that you get from an institution is generally on a 4-year basis. So meaning those grants, those institutional grants, the state grant that the state of Minnesota offers students to go to college, and the Pell Grant, which is a federal grant that offers students to go to college. You don't have to pay any of those back. And those are structured in four-year increments. Now, there might be a specialized institutional scholarship that might start when you're a junior, but your general financial aid package is going to be on a 4-year basis. It's hard for me right now to tell you how much your tuition is going to be reduced because I don't know your family situation. I don't know what GPA you have. I don't know what institutions you are looking at. You'll have to figure that out by yourself. But we know out of all of the 17 private colleges, those tuitions are on average reduced by 64%. So I don't want you to use that 64% and just take the tuition and be like, I'm going to get 64%, because that's an average of thousands of students in this whole system. But I do want it to communicate the fact that our students are receiving a lot of financial aid and a lot of grants that can reduce the price significantly. And I'm not able to tell you exactly how much your reduction is going to be. You'll have to work with the institution. And I guess one other thing that I'll mention that I really want to empower you all to do is you'll reach out to an institution, let's say it's St. Thomas, and you reach out and they connect you with an admissions rep, they are working for you to get you into that institution. It is in that admissions rep's best interest to find a way for you to be admitted. I know at the time it can feel like you have to convince them to admit you. And there's this culture of trying to impress an admissions rep. And I'm not saying that you shouldn't, but really you all have the power. They want you to go to their institution. It's their job to get you to go to their institution. So utilize that, reach out to them, ask them this exact same question. You know, you get the name and email from from St. Thomas with the admissions rep. Reach out to them, say, hey, you know, Bobby, what are my tuitions going to look like? What does my financial aid package look like? Put them on the spot, have them work for you. They will, and they'll be very responsive to prospective students like you. So be empowered, use those relationships with those admissions counselors to your advantage. Remember, they're looking at your application. And if you get to know them and they know that you're diligent, you're a nice person, you respond to emails, that's only going to go further to get you into those colleges. Create relationships with those admissions counselors. This is what's really going to set you apart from the thousands of other students that they're looking at. So that's another thing I would have you take away from this. It's the 4-year graduate rate, and be empowered to reach out to those admissions representatives at all your institutions. If I were looking at college right now, that's the first thing I would do, was reach out to the college and say, I'm interested in going to your college. They'll hook you up with an admissions rep. And then I would just keep in contact with them, ask questions, ask them, what are they looking in a writing sample? What are they looking for their GPA? Who should I get my recommendation letters from? Really use those resources. It's only going to best help you. Internships at these institutions, there are tons of internships. It's hard for me to say exactly, you know, what types of internships you're looking at. But remember, these institutions are some of the oldest institutions in the state of Minnesota. In fact, Hamline is the oldest higher education, Hamline, which is a private college in St. Paul, is the oldest higher education institution in the state of Minnesota, and has, you know, hundreds of years of creating deep, meaningful relationships with employers for internships. I graduated and got my master's degree from Augsburg University, and I had an internship at Mayo Clinic. It's just an example of these old, well-established institutions have really deep, long relationships with employers, and have paid, unpaid, all sorts of types of internships. And I would say internships are very, very important. Internships generally, you know, are later on in your higher education, your junior and senior year, you'll start looking for internships, and you'll be better candidates at that point. And you'll have a better understanding of what your major is going to be, what you're interested in. And that's when internships will play a role. An institution is going to have lists of internships that they have, but really those are going to be by department and based on relationships that you have. And I would say that if you go to a big school like the University of Minnesota, you're competing with tens of thousands. I mean, there's 60,000 students at the University of Minnesota. If you're interested in an internship at the University of Minnesota, how many students are you competing with for that internship? When I got my internship at Mayo Clinic, I was competing with 5 people. My chances were 1 out of 5 to get that internship. You'll be competing with thousands of people for those top internships at large institutions. And that's true for not just internships. That's true for, you know, if you want to be the president of the table tennis club, you can definitely do that at our institution. You have leadership opportunities, growth opportunities. You're not competing with tens of thousands of students who also, you know, the table tennis club's a few hundred people at the University of Minnesota, when it's like, you know, 20 people at our institution. So, you know, you have opportunities for leadership roles that including internships in a different way at a smaller institutions. The St. Kate's and St. Thomas are they part of the 7 colleges that you can take courses among? I mean, St. Thomas is the largest private institution in Minnesota. It's in St. Paul, and it used to have a relationship with St. Kate's. Now they're separate institutions. Yes, St. Kate's is a Minnesota private college. It's a wonderful, their undergraduate program is an all-women school, and it has a very fine history of educating women in the state of Minnesota. And if you are a woman, this is a school that you definitely need to be looking at if you're interested in going to a women's college. They're not affiliated anymore. St. Thomas is co-ed and accepts all sorts of different types of students. If you end up having to go to college for 6 years, would you be able to reapply for another financial aid? You would be able to apply for some financial aid. The major pieces of financial aid, including the state grant and the Pell Grant, you cannot. There is a maximum of 4 years. There's a dollar amount that you will have maxed out on, and you won't have an opportunity to reapply for those. There might be some institutional grants, meaning from the college rather than from the state or an external body. So the college gives, those are called institutional grants. There might be some, but there's probably not. They are, those grants and scholarships, they're interested in giving to new students. The students that are starting as first years in your fifth year and sophomores in their sixth year. I can't tell you that there wouldn't be and there will be zero, but I wouldn't count on it. And let's just say the colleges aren't counting on it either. They build their financial aid packages in 4-year increments. You know, obviously, especially if there's special reasoning, maybe you wanted to get an extra major or you wanted to play another year of soccer or something, there might be a way for the institution to make that work. I would say that's not something that you should rely on, and always think of those financial aid packages in 4-year increments. I think that's all the questions right now. I've got a couple clips of, and someone put in the chat if that video didn't work, just let me know. But I do have some clips of reps from our colleges who are talking about some common issues that I think are really important. Thank you, Beth. I appreciate that. I'll share a couple of those clips. They're from our colleges. Remember, I don't represent any one individual institution. But these individuals are, from institutions, so they can speak more specifically about, the specifics around those institutions. Okay. Let me share my screen again. I've got to optimize. I've got to go to this one and I'm going to play my cost. Is that? Oh no, that's a slide. I am not gonna share a video because they're not in the spot that I thought they were. So if you've got questions about individual institutions, I'd encourage you to reach out to those institutions. Like I said before, it's very important to create relationships with those admissions officers at the colleges that you're interested in. Whether it's a private college or not, creating relationships with admissions officers is very important, and will go a long way in helping you find the right outcome for you all. If there's no, I'm sorry that I don't have those videos ready. I thought I did. If there aren't any more questions, I'll leave a couple minutes early here, and you might have maybe time to start cooking dinner. Or is that just me that eats dinner at 5 o'clock?
There you go. Thank you, Tom. That was fantastic. We really appreciate all of you who are able to join us today. I want to note that when this window closes, you'll see a short 4-question survey. We'd really appreciate it if you fill that out. I want to encourage you, there's 6x6 sessions tonight where you can sign up and learn about 6 colleges really quickly.
Do that. Those are cool. Those are really efficient use of your time. You can
talk fantastic.
To colleges really quickly. Yes.
You can go out to www.strivescan.com/Minnesota and sign up for those for tonight or tomorrow. And note that recordings are going to be available for all of these at that same location. So we're really grateful to Tom and for all of you for coming. And I hope you have a great night.
Thanks, Beth.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye, everybody.